Did you know that as our hormones begin to fluctuate, that we actually, as women, have an increased risk of higher blood sugar levels? And that opens us up to an increased risk for diabetes, higher blood pressure, higher cholesterol, and even weight gain. Hi, I'm Sherry. I'm a menopause health coach, and I work with smart and independent women just like you. And through holistic methods, I can help you get comfortable in your skin again, regain your energy, your confidence, and your joy for life, so you can be living the sweet life once again. Now, I've been in the health and wellness industry for over 15 years, and if there's one thing I've become passionate about, it is that as women, we should be aging gracefully and powerfully. And I think one of the best ways we can do that is to become the driver of our own health story. So today I wanted to talk to you about when our hormones start to fluctuate and this increased risk of higher blood sugar level and what we can do to mitigate that. So estrogen plays a role with insulin and the way it works in the body. And insulin is the hormone that's responsible for helping the glucose, which is the blood sugar, enter into the cell. If we become insulin resistant, you can think of the glucose having a key and the cell that it's trying to get into as having a lock, and that key and lock no longer fit together. And so then the blood sugar just continues to build and build and build. So from a food standpoint, really what we want to try to do is control our hunger so that we're not overeating and our blood sugar levels aren't spiking. One of the best ways to do this is to make sure that you're eating high quality proteins and good healthy fats. The beauty about this is that they actually have a satiating quality. Eating proteins and healthy fats will actually make us feel fuller longer. And the great thing about protein is it has a very small spike effect on insulin levels. Healthy fats have no spiking of insulin. But if you go and you consume refined carbohydrates and sugars, that just will just spike that blood sugar level right up. So always try to incorporate, when you're having a meal, make sure that it's not just an all carbs meal. Make sure that there are some protein and healthy fats, and that will help keep your blood sugar level a little bit more balanced. Beans are another really great food to add to your diet. Again, they are incredibly healthy for you and they have that satiating effect. Another good trick is to start your meal off with like a nice big salad. Those big, beautiful leafy greens, not only are they healthy for you, they're gonna help fill you up so that you're actually eating less of your main meal. And then speaking of main meals, what comes after that? Dessert. Now, the great news is dark chocolate actually is so good for us. And when it comes to dealing with blood sugar levels, there is the stearic acid in dark chocolate that actually aids in digestion and kind of slows it down. And the bitterness of the chocolate actually helps inhibit our appetite. So little piece of dark chocolate at the end of the meal is fantastic. Just remember, this is for dark chocolate only, does not work for milk chocolate. Now, a few lifestyle habits that you can incorporate to help that blood sugar level is to eat slowly and really be mindful and chew your food and not be in such a rush. This really gives your brain time to catch up with where your stomach is so that it can signal, hey, I'm full. Another thing is lots of water. Hydrate, hydrate, hydrate. What many people don't realize is when they feel hunger, What it actually is you're thirsty. So make sure that you are drinking lots of water. It also is very beneficial as far as helping our body flush extra blood sugar or sugars out of our body through our urine. Exercise, another great lifestyle tip. As we exercise, it actually decreases the hormone ghrelin, which is the hormone that makes us feel hungry. And exercise increases the hormone leptin, which is the hormone that says, hey, I'm full. So try to get at least, 30 minutes of exercise in a couple of times a week. And then finally, my big favorite subject, sleep. Sleep is so critical. Much like exercise, getting the proper amount of sleep will help decrease ghrelin. Again, that's the hormone that's gonna make you hungry, and increase leptin, which is the hormone to make you feel full. Additionally, if we're not getting enough sleep, our cortisol levels start to climb. And as that happens, it actually, again, has an effect on insulin, and increased cortisol will actually increase our cravings for sugary, salty foods. So that just kind of puts you a little bit behind the eight ball. So I hope you found these tips inspirational and helpful. And if you feel like you're battling a little bit with sugar, I invite you to sign up for my 2-week program. It's Shake the Sugar Detox. I will go ahead and make sure that the link is available right here. And I hope you have a great week. Peace and love.